And staying with affordable housing and that price of 24 lakhs and even below, well, you could get set for more affordable housing stock in the Mumbai metropolitan region with the housing authority MHADA announcing plans to build 1,60,000 homes for the economically weaker sections of the society. The agency is doing this under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and expects to complete the project in 10 years. But is MHADA really up to the challenge, or will this again be a plan on paper? Nikhil Narayan Sivadas has this report.
The Prime Minister's vision of housing for all has got a giant boost in Maharashtra, all thanks to the Maharashtra Housing and Area Development Authority, or MHADA, which announced plans to build hundreds of thousands of low-cost, affordable homes in the state.
We are launching about 1,10,000 EWS and LIG houses on government lands, and that proposal is at the final stage. And of course, rest of the Maharashtra, apart from this MMR area, it will be about another 50,000. So we plan to launch about 1,60,000 houses in this financial year.
The project is being built under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, and MHADA has already identified 450 hectares of land in Thane, Raigad and Boisar to build these homes. The agency says these homes will be targeted exclusively at the economically weaker sections and the low-income group category.
Government of India is offering 1,50,000 as a subsidy, and Government of Maharashtra as a state share is offering 1 lakh from the state shelter fund. So basically these houses, which may cost around 10 lakh, 2.5 lakh will be coming from government sources. The rest we will have to take it from the beneficiary.
While those are impressive sounding numbers, they are in direct contrast to the recent state economic survey, which showed that the agency had only been able to construct 772 units in 2015-16. A sharp reduction in its numbers from the past 2 years. Former MHADA Chief Chandrasekhar Prabhu claims that the agency may not be able to deliver on its promise.
The reason why MHADA may not have built as many houses as possible is they may be under pressure from the builders. The politicians are always under the pressure from the builders to ensure that MHADA doesn't make enough houses. The government should have the guts to do that. If the government is really serious about the Prime Minister's this thing, then it will set targets to MHADA. And then MHADA will be forced to deliver.
If MHADA is able to deliver, it will have a huge impact. Most of the identified regions for the scheme will benefit, with large affordable townships coming up here, which in turn will spur further development. So how can we ensure that MHADA sticks to its promise? Real estate experts say the Real Estate Regulatory Bill, or RERA, could be key to doing this.
Once the projects are coming into market and a buyer is really buying that house from MHADA, even MHADA will have to be covered under Real Estate Regulatory Authority, RERA, in which case timely delivery, promised quality and specifications will also become so much more important for MHADA to deliver as per what they would have promised to those affordable housing buyers.
Lately, governments and local bodies have been vying with one another to launch affordable housing schemes. Now, is all this just a fad, or are we actually going to see units on the ground? Now, the good news is, with RERA coming in, even these government bodies will be held accountable, and we may actually see affordable homes come up across the state. From Mumbai, Nikhil Narayan Sivadas, NDTV.